Hi, I'm John from Fly78MikeAlpha.com, and I'll be your flight instructor today, taking you from the Sarasota International Class Charlie Airport down to the Venice Airport, which is a Class G or pilot-controlled airport about 20 miles south of here. We're going to go ahead, get the ATIS, call up clearance delivery, talk to ground control, eventually talk to tower, and then go ahead and talk to departure after we depart the airport and get VFR flight following en route back to Venice.
Key Ann Arbor Tower, right turn northbound approved, runway 24 cleared for takeoff.
Rare contact, squawk 0164, and climb the flight 2100. Key Ann Arbor, there's a lift to service, tower runway 14 cleared away.
First things first, let's go ahead and pull up our taxiway diagram and frequencies on our cell phone here or tablet. If you have paper charts, that works great too. And so we're right here at Dolphin, off of taxiway Alpha at Sarasota International. We're going to go ahead and get the ATIS for Sarasota International. That's 124375. We'll go ahead and write down this information, everything that's pertinent to us.
Information Alpha.
Information Alpha.
Meet your observation. Wind 020 to 10, gust 17, visibility 10, sky is clear, temperature 27, dew point 06, altimeter 3014, visual approach in use, landing and departing runways 32 and 04, notice stairman, runway 32 glide slope and localizer out of service. Ground control and clearance delivery combined on frequency 121.9. All aircraft readback runway assignments, hold short instructions, and advise initial contact, do you have information Alpha?
All right, we have information Alpha, we have our altimeter set, all of that information written down on our tablet here, or basically our cell phone. You could use your tablet, cell phone to write down, copy down that information, or you could just go ahead and use a pen and paper, that works great too on an e-board. So, information Alpha, that's important there that we have that. Now we're going to go ahead and call up clearance delivery, and we remember we heard clearance delivery combined on ground control 121.9er. So those are all combined on the same frequency, so ground control and clearance delivery on 121.9.
0114.
Someone else is getting their clearance right now, we'll wait for that to finish up there, he's going to go ahead and read it back. So what we're going to go ahead and do is call up clearance delivery, basically ground, and we'll say Sarasota ground, who we're calling, who we are, Cherokee 99 or 07 Whiskey, where we are at Dolphin with Alpha, and what we want to do. We want to go VFR to Venice at 1,600 feet. We'll go ahead and make that call, and then they'll have a clearance for us. Sarasota ground, Cherokee 99 or 07 Whiskey, at Dolphin with Alpha, VFR to Venice at 1,600.
Cherokee 99 or 07 Whiskey, Sarasota ground, after departure, sliding 240, maintain VFR to below 1,600, Tampa departure frequencies 119.65, squawk 0122.
On departure, fly heading 240, maintain VFR at or below 1,600, Tampa departure on 119.65, 0122 in the box, 07 Whiskey.
Cherokee 07 Whiskey, read back correct, advise ready to taxi.
And we complete all our checklists, we're ready to taxi, so we can go ahead and let them know that we're ready to taxi, and then we'll get our taxi clearance. Make sure you got your diagram ready.
72 Charlie, Sarasota ground from Dolphin Aviation. Runway 04, taxi via Alpha Delta.
We're in a non-movement area, we could taxi all the way up to the taxiway before calling and still move around here without a clearance, but we want to just stay right where we are until we get our clearance and then taxi out to the taxiway. Sarasota ground, Cherokee 99 or 07 Whiskey is ready to taxi.
Cherokee 99 or 07 Whiskey, Sarasota ground. Current winds 010 to 10, gust 14. Can you accept the runway 32 at Delta departure, 5,050 feet available?
07 Whiskey, like a full length on 4 or 32.
Cherokee 07 Whiskey, roger. Runway 32, full length, taxi via Alpha. Hold short of runway 4.
Runway 32, full length, taxi via Alpha, hold short of 407 Whiskey. And so we're told to taxi via Alpha here, all the way, full length, runway 32. Why didn't we take the intersection departure? That's 5,000 feet, that's better than what we normally fly out of. We normally fly out of 3,000 foot strips and 5,000 foot strips. But he said that we had over 5,000 feet available, 5,500 and change.
07 Whiskey, change of plans. We got an opposite direction coming in, runway 14, runway 04, taxi via Alpha Delta.
runway 04, taxi via Alpha Delta 07 Whiskey. All right, he just changed our plans there. Now he's sending us to runway 4. And runway 4 is shorter. It's only 5,000 feet or so. But why do we want a full length? Because we want to stack the deck in our favor. We don't want to set ourselves up for failure when we could just taxi a little further and have all that extra runway in front of us. What if we had an engine failure shortly after takeoff? Wouldn't you rather have some runway in front of you to land on rather than take that intersection departure and end up in the trees at the end of the runway? Set yourself up for success and stack the deck in your favor. Everything you possibly can do that's in your control, control it and set it up for a successful flight. Spend a little bit more time, a little bit more effort to go the extra mile and make sure you're not going to have a problem. So as we come up here, we're turning right on Delta as he instructed us. If we were unsure, we could stop, ask for progressive taxi instructions. We could check our taxiway diagram. It's okay to stop when you're taxiing and check your diagram. You don't want to stop for 10 minutes. But it's okay to stop and double check yourself rather than making a wrong turn and having a runway incursion or cutting off another aircraft. Alright, so as we come down the taxiway here, we're veering off to the right, and then we're going to angle ourselves off to the left. We don't really have the option to turn our aircraft into the wind to do a run-up today, but we can turn our aircraft slightly so that our prop wash does not hit all the other airplanes behind us should there be anyone else lined up behind us waiting for departure. We also make sure we get out of the way of that guy's prop wash so he's not going to hit us with his. We're going to go ahead and complete our run-up checklist, make sure all our before takeoff checklist is completed, and then we'll go ahead and program in our frequencies. We can do that now, actually, for 120.1 for our tower frequency.
114.
And 119.65 for our departure frequency. So that's all configured and all set up, ready to go for us right now. That we've got 120.1 for tower, 119.65 ready to go on takeoff. All we got to do is hit this flip-flop key right there, and we'll be all set. We're squawking the right code, 240 on departure, and we're going to go ahead and complete our run-up and before takeoff checklist. We've double-checked everything. We're all set.
Charlie Delta, flighting 360, contact camp departure.
We've got one airplane in front of us, so we're going to go ahead and call up the tower, let them know we're ready for departure, runway 4 in sequence. So there's one aircraft in front of us, and we could sneak past them, but let's not risk it. We're not going to try to taxi past them. Sarasota Tower, Cherokee 9090 Whiskey, ready for departure, runway 4 in sequence.
Cherokee 9090 Whiskey, Sarasota Tower, Roger. Number 2 is the Skyhawk ahead of you.
07 Whiskey, affirm.
07 Whiskey, Roger.
And so we let her know that we're ready to go, so as soon as she can get that Skyhawk out, we'll be ready to go right behind him, and we don't want to wait here forever. Obviously, we need good separation between aircraft, but the hop meter's running, it's costing us money. We'd really like to get out of here sooner rather than later. As we sit here and we got time to waste, we're just going to run through our checklist again, make sure we didn't miss anything. Stack the deck in your favor. Would you rather sit here and do nothing, or would you rather pull out a checklist and make sure you did everything very thoroughly and perfectly, and not have an issue on takeoff that you find, like leaving your fuel pump off, or having the flaps not set to the proper indication, not having your trim set where you want it, having a door unlatched at the top. Run through it again, take your time, make use of the time you've got to sit here and twiddle your thumbs. Oh, and by the way, welcome to a Class Charlie Airport. It's gonna cost you a lot just to taxi and take off. And if you think that's a lot, wait till you come in to land and it takes you 15 minutes of getting vectored around to land here. Soon you will surely appreciate the value of pilot-controlled airports where we control the airspace ourselves, and we make it work out a lot better than air traffic controllers do. We can see that this Skyhawk in front of us is actually doing a run-up now, and they must be a student. They're taking an extra long time to finish up, so we can go ahead and call up and let them know that we can squeeze by and get out in front of them if they have a spot available for us to take off. Yeah, Sarasota Tower, Cherokee 9090 some Whiskey. We do have room to squeeze by that Skyhawk if you can fit us out.
Cherokee 07 Whiskey, hold short runway 04, landing traffic short funnel.
Hold short 04, 07 Whiskey. Well, we always read back hold short clearances, even though we're already holding short of runway 4. We always read back hold short runway 4. Just to confirm that we are holding short, that's really to accentuate runway incursion avoidance. Special emphasis area on your private pilot check ride and commercial pilot check ride and any check ride. Special emphasis area, runway incursion avoidance. How are you going to avoid it? One of those ways is read back hold short instructions.
There's some Whiskey runway 04, line up and wait.
Live on runway 04, 07 Whiskey. All right, so we're going to squeeze by this Skyhawk here. He's a high wing, we're a low wing. We can come over here. Our wings can go underneath each other. We want to be very careful doing this. Hand on the brake, ready to stop if we need to. And we're clear. We're going to go ahead and line up and wait. Runway 4, that's our clearance. Taxi out, line up and wait. You're lining up and waiting for a takeoff clearance. You are not clear to take off.
2, Sarasota Tower. Are you squawking your own code?
Sarasota Tower 6012, we're squawking 1277. I think we just shifted to 1200 for you, squawking BFR.
And we're going to go ahead and taxi to the back here. We're using all the available runway. We're stacking the deck in our favor. We want all the available runway in front of us.
Whiskey traffic on the upwind departure and making right closed traffic. Turn left heading 240, runway 04, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, left heading 240, 07 Whiskey. All right, we are cleared for takeoff. Everything checks. Let's apply full power here.
From the field again, please.
Everything's in the green, applying full power. Got our crosswind correction in there. Airspeed's alive, looking good. Look down that runway, control and direction with rudder input. Go ahead and ease it back. We're rotation speed. We're flying, lowering the nose for 85. BY, clear all our obstacles.
We're just looking to transit your airspace to the east.
And we're going to go ahead and retract our flaps once we hit at least 200 feet. 200 feet or better till we can retract flaps.
Discard 6012, transition approved, altimeter 3012.
Looking for traffic here, we can lower our nose a little bit, we can make little S turns left or right. Coming up on 500 feet here, we're going to go ahead and make our left turn, 240.
Sarasota Tower, 666 Mike Kilo's, ready to depart runway 4.
2666 Mike Kilo, Sarasota Tower, Roger, able to get around the Skyhawk in front of you?
I don't think so, let's see if he'll move a little.
Tower Skyhawk 227 Charlie, hold short 4, Delta ready for departure.
2272 Charlie, Sarasota Tower, Roger.
And we're not touching our flaps just yet. We got our fuel pump on.
Whiskey flighting 240, contact Tampa departure.
240 over to departure, 07 Whiskey. All right, we're wings level. We're going over to departure. We're going to go ahead and set our flaps to zero. We can go ahead and get rid of our fuel pump at this point.
And Tampa approach RV10.
We're 1,000 feet. And we're climbing for 1,600 on 240 heading.
Roger, you can expect visual approach. Runway 32, descend and maintain 4,000.
Okay, we'll look for the visual 32, 4,000, 0 for November.
November 3318 Victor, you're ready.
And trying to get word in edgewise there.
Northeast of Sarasota, fly heading 190 Victor sequence for runway 32.
190 on heading, 18 Victor.
Checking for traffic. Tampa departure, Cherokee 990 07 Whiskey, leaving 1,400 for 1,006.
Number 9907 Whiskey, Tampa departure, ident for me.
Identing 07 Whiskey. All right, leveling off at 1,600. That was our altitude restriction that was given to us on our clearance before we took off.
Number 9907 Whiskey, radar contact a mile west of the Sarasota Airport. You just headed to Venice today?
That's affirmative, 07 Whiskey.
Number 9907 Whiskey, you can turn left on course for Venice. Maintain 1,600, I'll have lower again shortly.
Left on course to Venice, maintain 1,600, 07 Whiskey. And so he said he'd have lowers for us shortly, so we're turning on course to Venice. And lower for us shortly simply means he's going to have a lower altitude assigned to us shortly here, but he must have some traffic passing below us that he wants to keep us above. So as we're cruising along here, we have our landing light turned on. That is another special emphasis area. Collision avoidance technique, or collision avoidance procedures. What are you going to do to avoid a collision in midair? Leave your landing light on the whole flight. That's a good answer. As a renter, more than likely you don't pay for that landing light bulb. Leave it turned on.
Maintain 1,600, 2 miles east of Sarasota. Maintain 1,600.
Constantly scanning the sky for collision avoidance, looking around us, scanning in 10 degree sections. With our eyes.
019er Alpha, no traffic observed. Actually, there's
looking for any relative movement in our peripherals.
About a mile final for runway 5, 7 miles ahead of you there. Radar service is now terminated. You can remain on that beacon code. Actually, go ahead and squawk VFR and your frequency change is approved.
Thanks for your help today, sir. Appreciate you. See ya.
Okay.
And as we're flying along here to Venice,
Victor, flying 18.
There's a couple different things we can do to get over to the Venice CTAP and get rid of approach and our flight following. We could request simply to have a frequency change. We could just let them know that we have the Venice Airport in sight, and that may cue them up to say, all right, squawk VFR, frequency change approved, see you later. And that would allow us to put in 1200 in our squawk code and change our frequency over to Venice AWOL so we could get the Venice weather and then switch over after we have the weather to the Venice CTAF. If our radio is permitted, if we had the right kind of radios, we could monitor. If we had two comm radios, we could monitor the Venice CTAF. As we fly out here.
7 Whiskey, VFR descent approved at your discretion. Advise when you get Venice Airport in sight.
VFR descent approved, my discretion. We'll advise the Venice Airport in sight, 07 Whiskey. And so we're going to go ahead and descend out over the water here. VFR descent is approved, our discretion. And we'll advise the Venice Airport in sight.
125.3449.
And we can go ahead and report the Venice Airport in sight.
7 Whiskey, VFR traffic for you, 1 o'clock, 2 miles, northbound 2,700 indicated.
Looking for traffic, 07 Whiskey, and we have the Venice Airport in sight.
Thank you.
F1A Victor with the traffic.
And so normally he would hand us off at that point, but because there is traffic that could be a factor for us, he's going to go ahead and hold on to us for a little bit longer, just as a courtesy, keeping us advised of that traffic that we don't see. He said 1 o'clock, 2 miles, 2,000 feet, slightly above us.
Cessna 1A Victor.
November 104, November, turn right, heading 180 Vector sequence.
We're looking for that traffic, still don't have it.
Number 9907 Whiskey, traffic east of you now, no factor. Radar services are terminated. Squawk VFR, frequency change is approved.
Radar services terminated. Squawk and VFR, frequency change approved. 07 Whiskey, see ya.
November 492 Foxtrot, Zulu Tampa, departure right end for me. Climb and
so we'll go ahead and get the AWOS over at Venice now.
102 Foxtrot.
9663, contact Sarasota Tower now, 120.1.
We'll also program in 1200 for our squawk code. So we're squawking VFR, we're flying visually, VFR visual flight rules. We got the Venice CTAF dialed in there. We'll go ahead and dial in the Venice AWOS. Venice AWOS, unfortunately today is out of service and we can't get the weather. So we plan to overfly the field at 1,500 feet, 500 feet above traffic pattern altitude. Look down for the windsock, identify what it's doing, maybe talk to other airplanes on the pattern, see what runway they're using, and then go ahead and enter the traffic pattern for that. We'll go ahead and monitor the CTAF from here on out.
And so the rest of the way into Venice here, we're going to go ahead and fly down the coast, overfly the field 500 feet above traffic pattern altitude at 1,500, look down, figure out what the windsock's doing. Looks like it's going to favor runway 23 here. And then we're going to go ahead, depart the traffic pattern, wrap back around, and enter the traffic pattern on the left downwind at a 45 degree angle, and then go ahead and make our full stop landing. And this is what it ultimately looks like. Thanks so much for watching. Leave your questions in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video. Also, check us out on Patreon. That's how we actually fund all these videos here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope you fly safe and fly every day. If you don't fly every day, then fly at MikeAlpha.com. See y'all next time.
Detroit 118.95 today.
Detroit on 1895. Great, thank you. Have a good one.